Welcome to another brilliant show of At Your Vice, where we speak with entrepreneurs on a weekly basis and we help grow business in your part of the world. My name's Gilemi. I am happy to have you on the show, and today we'll be taking a trip back in time to the board game called Monopoly. Now, if you had the opportunity of playing Monopoly, then you should count yourself very fortunate, because millennials will most probably just stay on their phones and not learn these basic steps that you learned as a child that can be implemented in business. So today's topic is going to be about business principles that we learned playing Monopoly that you can apply in business. Okay, so the first thing I'd like to speak about is passing go. So the main objective in Monopoly was to get to the most important plots, vacant land, whatever you want to call it, as quickly as possible, so that you can get that competitive edge over your players that's playing with you, so that you can create an income by means of them having to pay when they do land on it. And the same principle applied to business. The sooner you get your idea off the ground into a working business model, the sooner you're going to get competitive advantage about anyone else wanting to start maybe the same business. But more importantly, you get to get clients and market share sooner than what they do. The next pointer is buying the most expensive properties first. A lot of players play it safe and they rather buy one of the brown plots, the first one as you go past the go. I myself enjoy going for either the green, yellow or purple properties, because I knew that buying those properties first would put me in a competitive advantage, getting a bigger income once I'm able to put on houses and hotels, etc. But in business, you need to be careful that you don't cripple your business by investing too much too quickly. Make sure, and it once again boils down to having a plan, a business plan. Make sure that whatever you put capital towards, that it's something that's viable, that will create an income for you. Yes, it's a startup and there's going to be hurdles and things that you're not aware of unless you actually start doing the business. But it's vitally important to plan accordingly and make sure that you don't put all your eggs in one basket. Okay, so the next one is location, location, location. Once again, with Monopoly, the better properties you buy, the better advantages you have. And the same applies to business. When you decide to put up shop, make sure that you look at the location. It's all fair and well if you pay a minimal amount for a business area that you can utilize, but if you don't have the feet clients that would come to your business, then it's actually pointless. So make sure that when you look at a location, that you take into consideration the money that you're paying per month, the actual scope of clients that you can gather by means of being in that particular place. Rather pay a little bit more but get more exposure for your business.
This is Consult on the Go's tip of the week. My name is Gerard Brandt from BFS Consult, and today we're talking about provisional tax. Now, if you have a business in your personal capacity, or you have a company, or you have registered a trust, you need to pay provisional tax. For individuals, it will be at the end of February and August that you will have to pay, and for trust as well. For companies, it all depends on when your year end is. If you need any assistance, give us a call.
Okay, so the next point is develop properties. Now, besides the fact that you want to get to the most expensive properties first, it's also key that you actually purchase all the colors so that you actually are in a position to put up homes and hotels. And the same applies to business. As in the board game, you're not necessarily going to land on all three colors within the first three rounds that you do. It's going to take some time, and it's all again going down back to planning. Don't build faster than what you can afford. Make sure that you make provision for the what ifs. Like I said, you're not going to land on all those colors in the first three rounds, so you need to plan accordingly if you want to gain all three greens or reds or whatever the color you're going for. Then make sure that you plan accordingly. Make sure that for the what ifs, like when you land on it, you got to pay someone because they've got that particular plot. Make sure that in business as well, that you make provision for the what ifs. Okay, so the next pointer is taking chances. Manage risk and reward. As per the board game, you have community chest and the chance pile of cards, and evidently somewhere along the line you might either pick up one or two cards, advance to go or go directly to jail. And the same applies in business. there is chances, or at least opportunities for you to take chances, but those chances needs to be calculated chances that you take. And I've got two pieces of advice that I want to give you. One is get a mentor that you can speak with. When you get to a position where you don't really know what to do in that particular instance, speak to mentors. And secondly, trust God. Always, always, always make Jesus part of your business. I can tell you that is most probably the biggest thing that you can do to make sure that your business grows from where it currently is to where it needs to go. Give Jesus ownership in your business and you will see it skyrocket. So the next point is community chest. We did speak about those pack of cards just now. But in the community chest pack of cards, whenever you pick it up, you might have to pay a municipality, pay school fees. It's generally always stuff to do with having to maintain something or, as I put it, giving back. And the same applies to business in life. When you have an opportunity to give back, do so. Because what you sow, you will reap. And once again, that's a biblical principle. So make sure that when you are in a position to have a social responsibility, then do that. I mean, as an example, I would much rather support a business if I know that that business is actually contributing to either a shelter for animals or looking after babies that hasn't had parents. So do your bit in making sure that your social responsibility is up to date, because that as well will give you the opportunity to gain more clients because of your responsibility. And then the last pointer is don't go to jail. So as on the board game, if you land up in go to jail, you either pay a fine for it or you sit out for a couple of rounds, which makes you lose an opportunity to get an advantage in the business or in the board game. But the same applies to business. Don't do business with the incorrect morals. Have integrity. Be upfront with your clients. Be honest and make sure that your business is done in such a way that others would want to do business with you. So I trust that you've enjoyed these short 7 snippets of business advice that we picked up as children in playing Monopoly. And I really believe that if you implement them, your business can definitely go from where it is now to even bigger heights. So thank you for joining, and don't forget, follow us on Facebook, share our videos, because somewhere along the line an entrepreneur might just pick up something that we've said, someone that we've spoken to that can change their business. We'll see you next week.